Welcome back, guys, to Jurassic's Edge. Your host, Alessandro Guerra, and today I am bringing you guys another video review of the brand new sculpt, the one, the only, the 100th version of Blue. Now, guys, I want to make something real clear, real quick. I'm sorry I haven't been uploading lately. Unfortunately, we had a Hurricane Dorian coming in, almost hitting my area, so I had to prepare, I had to get everything ready, you know, I had to barrier up the house, and I was really busy these past couple of days. You know, my sympathy goes out to everyone up in Palmetto Beach and going up north, Georgia, you know, North and South Carolina. I know the hurricane's making its way north, and of course, everyone in the Bahamas, y'all have my support. If you guys want to give back to the Bahamas, you guys can give supplies to your local fire department and they can send those supplies to the Bahamas and give back, guys. It's always important. I always encourage that in this channel, that, you know, support, kindness, and always giving back is the best thing you can possibly do as a human, because, you know, you guys might be living a great time and a happy life, but someone else can be in great misery. So it's always good to give back. And if you guys can, you know, give back in the slightest and smallest way, it can always create a big, happy, and forever lasting smile. So now getting into the review, as you guys can see, we got Blue. That rhymed. As you guys can see, we come back to the review with Blue. Yeah, guys, this is the new mold of the Savage Strike Blue that was just released with the Dilophosaurus, the new Velociraptor, and the Pachy. And I can honestly say that this Blue has actually caught my eye. I actually like the way he looks. He is different. We don't get another re-release of the Jumping Blues. Oh my God, do I hate those Jumping Blues. I've seen them everywhere and they're just fucking getting all over my head, man. I can't stop from, I mean, they just, it's like they're stalking me, dude. Everywhere I go, they're just there. I went to Marshall's today to pick up my daughter some clothes. And he was just there staring at me, guys. He was just there with Owen in the two-pack. I can't believe that they're still out. And they're out there in numbers, guys. They have armies out there. But moving on. Moving on here, guys. As you guys can see, the box. We got the standard Dino Rivals packaging, as you guys can tell. And in the back here, you guys can see we have Blue. Now, the difference with this Blue is now he has the arm-slashing features. You guys can see right there. Very nice. I've reviewed them all except for the Monolophosaurus, as you guys can tell. I will be reviewing him very, very soon, guys, so stay tuned. Got the collector card right here. Possibly one of the best stats we can get in any of these collector cards. Of course, Blue, very dominant, strong, healthy dinosaur. I mean, smartest of the smarts. Velociraptor, guys. Now let's get him out of the packaging and let's see what he's all about, guys. Alright, guys, I'm gonna get right into Blue since the collector card is exactly the same as we've seen it before in the previous Savage Strike release of the Blue that we've gotten before. So starting off here, as you guys can see in the head, brand new head sculpt, very nice, very slimmed out face, very blue in essence. You guys can see the eye right there is a yellow color, colored in there perfectly, no sloppiness. You guys can see that very reptilian black streak of a pupil that we have right there. All gray in color, of course. The top of the head is very nice and sculpted. As you guys can see, very prominent bumps and scales that are a lot bigger that come from the beginning of the snout right here all the way through the middle, and smaller scales that follow up around the head portion. The blue is very prominent, and of course, I cannot stress this enough, guys. For when you release Blue as a figure, no matter what it is, it's very essential and important that you contain the white kind of silverish color that surrounds the Blue. That just that's like the insignia of Blue right there. You guys gotta have that. And they always apply this to the figures, and I'm very happy for that. Now moving on to the interior of the mouth. Very nice. Nice hot pink in there. You guys have the teeth nicely sculpted and colored in. As you guys can see, they're kind of a yellowish color. Actually, I can see up here in the mouth. I don't know if you guys can see that nicely. But the teeth aren't colored in all the way to the top. It's kind of a bummer, but it's acceptable. And we can move on from that. It's nothing too big. Now moving on to the neck. The neck is nicely sculpted. As you guys can see, they got the kind of lizard-like flap right there. Nice creasing right here along the neck. The neck is articulated, goes up and down all the way around. And as you guys move down to the arms are very nice in sculpt. We got brand new sculpted arms. The arm claws are not painted, but no biggie. The arms are very muscular, guys. With the stats of this guy, he should look very muscular. His strength is at an all-time high. So the arms are articulated. They go all the way out, all the way in. They go all the way around. They're on a ball joint. And that goes along with the action feature, which I'll show you right now. You guys have got to see that button on top. You got to press that. And the arms slash around like that. So he looks like he's running. The stripe obviously continues on both sides all the way down to, surprisingly, almost the tip of the tail. Almost the tip of the tail, guys. We lucked out a little bit there. We almost got it all the way to the tip of the tail, but that's all right, guys. They made an effort. I mean, the tail being colored to me is like, Mattel barely ever does that. But coming on down, you guys can see kind of a yellowish color on the belly portion of the figure. That comes down actually towards the tail, guys. It makes its way all the way down to the length of the tail. Very nice. And as you guys can see, the feet and the legs are very, very muscular. They have a new position, new sculpt. Everything about this figure is a brand new sculpt. That is why I do very much recommend you guys pick them up if you guys haven't. This is probably one of the best looking blues we have gotten so far. So pick them up, guys. Limited stock. I cannot find them anywhere. I have found them only once and I haven't seen them again. So pick them up. As you guys can see, the legs are very muscular. Very nice detail along the legs. Very nice little minute creasings. The calf is, you guys can see all that muscle detail in there. Very bird looking legs. The toe claws are painted. You guys can get a nice clear view of that. The arm claws are not painted, but the toe claws are. The legs are articulated in and out, just like that. And the leg, I think, goes 360. Yes, yes, it goes 360, guys. But guys, I stress this a lot when it comes to Mattel figures. Do not stress out the joints and the articulation, guys, because they will wear out. I just did that once, and mine is already very loose. So I recommend you guys don't do anything stupid with your figures, guys. Be very smart with them. If you guys want to have them for the long run, if they're for kids, do as you please. But if you're a collector, try not to stress out the figure as much, because it will get loose and it will be very hard to pose later on in the future. So that's pretty much all I have to say about this blue right here. I mean, all I can do is now show you guys some side-by-side comparisons, compare them to the older versions of the blues. And here you guys, we have the new blue next to one of the few of the army overstocked blues that we always get, the jumping blue that comes with the two-pack with Owen. And the best version of blue that we have gotten, in my opinion, the one, the only, Battle Damage blue. Now, I can see why they've released all these blues. They are all unique in their own individual way. But when it comes to look and to accuracy, my favorite would have to be the Battle Damage version, because it stands upright. You can do a lot with them. The coloration is just spot on, the detail is spot on, the legs look fantastic, the head sculpt's fantastic, and as you guys can see, of course, we got the Battle Damage. So I'm gonna have to go with this blue right here as being my favorite version of all the blues we've gotten. Now the Attack Pack blue, I know I don't have him up here, but we've all seen him and he's trash, so I'm not even gonna compare him to these guys. This blue right here, he's just, looks like he's a size 24 in foot. I'm not even gonna get into him. I already give this guy like a 2 out of 10. I'm gonna give this blue right here a 10 out of 10, because I'm in love with this blue, absolutely spectacular. Whenever I do photo shoots with my figures, this is the blue I use for representation. Now this blue right here, he holds a pretty close tie to this guy right here. I'm gonna have to give this blue right here a 7 out of 10. I'm gonna give him a 7 out of 10 simply because of the fact that this blue, there's just something there, guys. Something there's like a little missing to me. I guess it's probably the relationship I have with this blue right here. I guess it's just I've been in love with him for so long that I just hold him to the top, guys. I don't know, this blue just looks too much. It's just the movement we got going on with him. He's got more fluid looking features to the tail though, because he does have a curvature to the tail. You guys can tell. But other than that, this blue is just straightforward. Looks beautiful, guys, in comparison. And I absolutely recommend that if you're gonna pick up a blue, pick this guy up right here. The Battle Damage Walmart exclusive blue. And we've made it to that portion of the video, guys. My thoughts, my opinion of this blue is very nice. He is not a bad sculpt. He does represent blue in every way. The only thing about it is I'm not a big fan of the pose. I don't like him slouching down a little bit like that with his tail kind of up like that. I don't like it. I like the standard pose, but that's just me nitpicking, guys. It's just my personal thought about dinosaurs. I like my dinosaurs to be in a neutral position, guys. I don't like this action-like pose. But, I mean, from a standpoint, he gets everything across that blue should have. We got the blue streak, we got the gray colors, we got the very blue-like face, and we got the nice new addition to the curved tail. And of course, the brand new action features. So what more can you guys ask for, guys? Now, if I see another blue, I am gonna go crazy. I don't want any more blues, guys. No more blues, I get it. We get blues and Owens like crazy. I don't know why. Release a Claire, man. Release a Claire with a baby Stegosaurus or something. Take your mind and go elsewhere, guys. Maybe release a Claire with a Triceratops and a Triceratops baby. But stop it, guys, with the blues and the Owens. We get it. They represent the line. And I understand why you guys keep releasing him, but just stop it. I'm gonna go bankrupt the blues. He's gonna be responsible for my bankruptcy. But anyways, guys, all jokes aside, this guy gets a good rating from me. I give him a 7 out of 10. He's a pretty average figure. Now, if you guys are to pick him up, you guys can. You know, in my personal opinion, if I were to choose between the blues, like I said, the Battle Damage blue is the one to choose. Looks more accurate, has the best pose of all the figures. So there you have it, Dino Loving Family. The Savage Strike blue, with all of my initial thoughts and everything that he has to offer, you guys have just seen. Tell me down in the comment section below what you guys thought. Did you pick him up? Would you pick him up? Did you guys like this blue better than all the other blues? Is this your favorite blue? Let me know in the comment section below. And tell me, guys, what kind of position and pose would you like your blue figure to be? I know they released the Super Colossal blue. I know they wanted to go big on that one, boy. They said go big or go home, motherfucker. They said go big or go home. They released the Super Colossal blue, guys. A Super Colossal blue. Oh my god. My daughter can literally ride that thing. That thing is so big. I saw Andy's Dinosaurs reviews on the Super Colossal blue. If you guys haven't checked him out, go check him out. He pretty much reviews everything. He uploads daily, guys, so you guys don't want to miss out on that. He's a good friend of mine. We always keep communication, and he's good people. So you guys should go check him out. He really gives a lot to the Jurassic community, and he does a lot for us fans. So guys, go support him if you haven't already. The link and his name is going to be right here. So yeah, guys, that's all I have to say about this video. You know, I love you all. Thank you all for liking and subscribing to my channel. Thank you all for tuning in. If you guys want me to review anything else or any other specific figures, let me know in the comment section below and I will get to it. Now remember, guys, I will be releasing a Mosasaurus as a giveaway to my 200 subscribers. The 201 subscriber does not count. Has to be the 200 subscribers. So I will gather up all you guys and I will do a raffle, and you guys are gonna earn yourself a brand new in package, beautiful looking Mosasaurus, guys. He's getting rarer to find, and having a mint in package is gonna be a blessing in the future. And he's gonna be all yours to have and to love. All you have to do is just to subscribe, having commented on my channel. I will be reviewing next all of the Roarvores that came out, the new Roarvores, which are pretty much all just repaints. I'm gonna get into them though. They're gonna be the next ones I review. So, you guys know the jits. You all have my heart and support. I love you all. Stay dino strong. And I'll see you all very, very soon. Peace. Are you ready? Hey. Is you ready? Ready? You say you ready? Oh. Whole squad ready? Ready? Hey girl, is you ready? Huh? Are you ready? Ready? Is you ready? Whole squad ready? We came here to see Jeff. What you got? Oh. No, no, no.
got, I'm going to the top. You can bring what you got, I'm going to the top. Bring what you got. Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. I'm going to the top. Are you ready? You know what time it is, right? They don't want us to make it, so it's time to take it. Rhyme with them killers, it's time to see who be realer. Unload the empty, the clip on them, make sure these people feel it. I'm shooting like Reggie Miller, don't move or I'ma hit you. Half a pound, toe to toe, yeah, I call it Thriller Manila. Scope on them, be no motion picture, hit you from distance. We came out the trenches with the stitches, God is my witness. And I gotta get that first shot out before that bullet hit me. I ain't gotta worry about looking back with my squad with me. Are you ready? Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready? Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready? Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready. We came here to see Jet. What you got? No, no, no. Not on my watch.
No way.
Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. You can bring what you got. I'm going to the top. Bring what you got. Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. I'm going to the top.
Hopping out that truck with the killers looking like Thriller. I'm ready for the million, talk to myself in the mirror. Is you ready? Jump off in that Bentley with no ceiling. Is you ready? Is you sick of taking losses, time for winning. They can't hang with us, can't bang with us. They know we arm and dangerous. If you think you fucking with my squad, you better hang it up. We been grinding hard, can't take that from us. We been grinding hard on the job, can't take that from us.
Are you ready? Is you ready?